40,000 people flocking to Punta Gorda this weekend for the 37th annual Florida International Air Show.
NBC2's Alex Howard is breaking down how this event is giving the area an economic boost, packing our local hotels and restaurants.
It's great for the air show industry. People love aviation, and we like promoting it for the youth as well.
Visitors from across the country came to Punta Gorda to watch history take flight.
Air show fans travel far distances to come see air shows in various other venues. So we'll be very often down at Punta Gorda, and people say they came from Georgia, they came from North Carolina just to see the show.
Thousands flocking to the small city for the weekend, staying in hotels, shopping in the stores, and eating in the restaurants.
First of all, it draws a lot of people, and it's a big source of income for all kinds of different people in the area.
Terry Jordan drove up from Cape Coral to live his dream of flying in a World War II fighter aircraft.
I got all kinds of just adrenaline going through my head right now. It's just got off the airplane.
But the reach of the three-day event goes beyond the vendors and those flying here. For many, it's a trip back in time.
That's why we do this here, too, is to bring our history in as well.
Tom Smith of Sarasota is one of the few owners left of a working Vaultee BT-15.
Of this very type, this is a BT-15, there's only four still flying in the world. This is one of them.
Stored here in Punta Gorda year-round, Tom has been displaying his vintage plane at the air show for the past 10 years. And he's not the only one.
A great warbird community here. Our EAA Warbird Squadron, Florida Warbirds 24 is here. And I have a lot of friends with the hangar, so we actually hang right here on the airport with the others.
Making Punta Gorda a mecca for the fans of flight.
So we were here last year, we're here this year, and just come out, be part of it, experience it, bring the family, and just come out here and do it.
That was Alex Howard reporting. Now, if you missed the fun today, don't worry. You can still make it out tomorrow for the final day of that air show. You can count on NBC2 to be there, too.